You may have noticed a lot more talk of rats running around Ottawa, whether you've seen them yourself or just heard the many stories.
But for most, this likely isn't their view. Rats frolicking, jumping on children's toys. This is filmed in a backyard on this street here in Kanata. It's part of a row house with four units that people living in say is infested with rats.
We hear them screaming all the time. We hear them running, screaming, fighting. And at night, it was like a nightmare. No one can understand except who lived in this situation.
This has been going on for about 3 months, and they said it's like a horror movie, but in real life.
It was so bad, Heba Waspy moved across the world just to escape it. She left in August, leaving her house vacant, but bought 5 cameras to monitor the rats all the way from United Arab Emirates.
If somebody told me before about living with this situation, I know that I would never imagine that. The rats literally live around us.
Residents say it allegedly started at one unit at the end, and it's been spreading from one home to the next.
We called 311. We called the city. We called the fire department. We called everyone that we screamed for help, but no one took it seriously.
The city says they've issued an order for an owner on their street to clean his home by September 30th and conduct pest control or charges may be laid. Just days before the deadline, the owner appealed one of the orders and has now been given until the end of this week to comply. CBC has reached out to the owner for comment but didn't receive any response. Kim Holland, the third neighbor, took me on a tour through her home to see what the rats have been up to there.
This is coming down our basement where typically the rats were coming in. If you notice, I've been a little scared, so I have to make sure the doors are closed and I make lots of noise just in case there are any friends. If you notice on the floor, we've had lots of traps. We've had 2 dead that we found in this room.
All of their homes have been damaged. Chewed wires, drywall, water lines, insulation. Each neighbor said they spent thousands of dollars in repairs and on ways to prevent more rats from getting in.
And how big is the biggest one you've seen?
I haven't seen them, but my husband certainly has. So you're looking at about a 7-inch body and a 9-inch tail.
That is
large.
Big.
Very, very large. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She walked me through the communal yard where they frolic. We were just standing around chatting when all of a sudden...
I just saw one.
Oh, please. Okay, I'm glad. That's okay.
We could see a rat jump inside one of the houses.
There's one over there. That's why we could smell. Okay, all right. I believe you, honey. I believe you.
Alive or dead?
It was dead, and boy, could you smell it. Neighbors say that smell consumes their homes, so in desperation to get rid of it all, they all turn to pest control companies, just adding to the list of costs.
I do feel that I should be compensated for the stress, the trauma, the cost, either through that source or the city. You know, this is why I'm here, to find out what are we supposed to do? Who do we go to? Who is responsible? I know I didn't bring the rats into my home.
And when it comes to rats, experts say they need to be dealt with quickly.
And especially now that we're getting into the fall season, this is when what we call it's rodent season. This is when rats and mice that tend to spend more time outdoors in the warm summer months, just like us humans, they're just flocking into our homes looking for that warm, secure areas to survive.
And well, it turns out rats breed like rats.
They breed every 21 days and they have litter sizes anywhere from 6 to 14. So, you know, you do the math on that and, you know, a pair of breeding rats, research has shown that they can reproduce in 1 year over 10,000 offspring.
People living in the homes hope the rats disappear soon before more babies appear in the dozens.